Hi dear students, welcome to Geeta's classes. In this class, we are going to learn how to apply convolution theorem. The main use of convolution theorem is to find the inverse Laplace transform. So we know that if L of f of t is f bar of s, then L inverse of f bar of s is f of t. Okay? And please memorize these formulas, and the proofs are available in the previous classes, and each and every theorem, every formula is important, okay, with the proofs. Even inverse Laplace transform is also important. So now coming to convolution theorem, before going to the convolution theorem, we should understand what is the convolution of two functions. So if you have two functions f of t and g of t, these are two functions defined for t greater than 0, then f of t star g of t, this star is not just a multiplication, this is called convolution, okay. This represents the convolution product. So f of t star g of t is defined as integral 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u du. That is, first function t is replaced by u, and in the second function t is replaced by t minus u, okay. Assuming that the integral exists. So, f of t star g of t is called the convolution product of the two functions f of t and g of t. And please note, whether you write f of t star g of t and g of t star f of t, both are going to be the same. That is, in the place of f of u, you can write g of u into f of t minus u also fine. Okay, according to the convenience, you can change them. Coming to convolution theorem, if you have two functions L of f of t is equal to f bar of s and L of g of t is g bar of s, Laplace transform of the convolution product of two functions is equal to product of their Laplace transform separately. That is, f bar of s is L of f of t, g bar of s is L of g of t. So taking their Laplace transform separately and just to take the product. Okay, that is, from this you can write L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s is equal to f of t star g of t. So how is this going to be useful for our inverse Laplace transform? If you have to find out the inverse Laplace transform of product of two functions of s, f bar of s and g bar of s, you can find out the inverse Laplace transform separately and take the convolution product between the functions. Okay, so if you have L inverse of f bar of s into g bar of s, find the inverse Laplace transform of f bar of s separately, which is our f of t, and find the inverse Laplace transform of g bar of s, that is our g of t. Then don't just multiply, take the convolution between f of t and g of t. Convolution product of f of t and g of t will give you the inverse Laplace transform of f bar of s and g bar of s. So this is the main use of convolution theorem. Okay, let us do some problems. So if you have to find out inverse Laplace transform of product of two functions of s, that is 1 by s plus a, 1 by s plus b. So here, what is f bar of s? 1 by s plus a. G bar of s is 1 by s plus b. Okay. So what is f of t? Inverse Laplace transform of, that is L inverse of 1 by s plus a, which is e power minus a t. And L inverse of g bar of s, g of t is equal to L inverse of g bar of s. G bar of s is what? 1 by s plus b, which is equal to e power minus bt. Okay. So L inverse of 1 by s plus a into 1 by s plus b is equal to e power f of t star g of t. That is convolution product of f of t and g of t. So by definition, it is integral 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u du. Okay, let us substitute the function. So L inverse of 1 by s plus a into 1 by s plus b is equal to integral 0 to t What is f of t? It is e power minus a t. G of t is e power minus b t. So f of u means e power minus a u into g of t means g of t minus u. So e power minus of minus b into, in the place of t I have to write t minus u into du. That is integral 0 to t e power minus a u into e power minus b t into e power b u into du. So t is independent of u, so I can take it outside. So e power minus b t into 0 to t e power minus of a minus b into u du. That is e power minus b t into e power minus of a minus b into u divided by minus of a minus b from 0 to t. E power, with respect to u, you are integrating. So whatever is there, the coefficient, that you have to write it in the denominator. Okay. Now applying the limits. That is e power minus b t into, upper limit is t. In the place of u, you have to substitute a t. And I am going to take that b minus a outside. E power minus b t divided by b minus a into e power minus a t. Minus a minus b. Into t minus. In the place of u, you have to substitute t and 0. And e power 0. That is equal to e power minus bt by b minus a into, I can take this e power minus bt inside. So e power minus bt into e power minus at into e power bt. Okay, if you expand this, minus e power 0 is 1, 1 into e power minus bt, e power minus bt. Okay, so here e power minus bt and e power plus bt will get cancelled. So 1 by b minus a into e power minus at minus e power minus bt. This is the answer. Okay. Next is L inverse of s by s squared, 1 by s into s squared plus 4. So let us take f bar of s is equal to 1 by s and g bar of s is equal to 1 by s squared plus 4. So what is f of t? L inverse of 1 by s, that is 1. And g of t is equal to L inverse of 1 by s squared plus 4. Here 4 I can write it as 2 squared. And s squared plus a squared means 2 is missing. Whatever is missing you multiply and divide. Therefore 1 by 2 into sine 2t. So required inverse Laplace transform is 1 by s into s squared plus 4 is integral f of t star g of t. F of t star g of t. What is f of t? It is 1. Okay. So integral, by definition, integral 0 to t f of u into g of t minus u. That is 1 into g of t minus u. Wherever you have t, you replace it by t minus u. So sine 2 into, in the place of t, I am writing t minus u into du. So 1 by 2 can be taken outside and integral 0 to t sine of 2t minus 2u du. That is equal to 1 by 2 into integral of sine 2t minus 2u with respect to u. Therefore minus cos of 2t minus 2u. With respect to u, you are integrating. So, I am going to write minus 2 in the denominator from 0 to t. So, this minus and minus will become plus. So, 1 by 4 into cos of, substitute u is equal to t. So, cos of 2t minus 2t. Minus of cos of 2t minus 0, that is cos 2t. Okay. That is 1 by 4 into cos 0, it is 1, 1 minus cos 2t. That is the answer. Next problem, L inverse of 1 by s into s squared plus 1. So here let us take f bar of s is equal to 1 by s squared plus 2s plus 2 and g bar of s is equal to 1 by s. For my convenience, you can take anything, f bar of s also 1 by s and g bar of s 1 by s squared plus 2s plus 2 also you can take, nothing wrong in that. But this will be convenient because again t minus u I am replacing, no, the second function. So if it is 1, then it will be easy for us, that's why. So f of t is equal to L inverse of 1 by s squared plus 2s plus 2. That is L inverse of, whenever you have in this denominator square, you have to write it as s plus a or s minus a. Okay. So here 1 by s squared plus 2s. I have 2 here. So 2 into 1. So plus 1 plus 1. Okay. So you, if you want to know how to split these numbers in detail, I have explained in that first shifting theorem. Okay. First shifting theorem for inverse Laplace transform. In that class, I have done 2-3 problems regarding using this same method. You can understand if you want to understand in detail. So, L inverse of 1 by s plus 1 the whole square plus 1. That is, whenever you have s plus a or s minus a, e power minus a t or plus a t, you have to take it outside. So, e power minus a t into L inverse of and replace s plus 1 by s. So, 1 by s squared plus 1. That is e power minus t into sin t. Okay. What is g of t then? L inverse of 1 by s, which is equal to 1. Therefore, L inverse of 1 by s into s squared plus 2s plus 2 is equal to f of t star g of t. So, here f of t is e power minus t sin t we have taken and g of t is 1. Okay. So, by definition integral 0 to t e power minus t minus u sin u into 1 into du. Okay. So, what is that? L inverse of 1 by s into s squared plus 2s plus 2 is equal to integral 0 to t e power minus u. Into sin u du. So we know the formula in the previous classes I have explained. Integral of e power ax sin bx dx is equal to e power ax by a squared plus b squared. This is a formula. Into a sin bx minus b cos bx. If it is a power ax into cos bx, a cos bx plus b sin bx. Okay, that is the formula. See here what is a? A is equal to minus 1. You compare this integral with this required integral. So a is equal to minus 1, b is equal to 1. Therefore, this is equal to integral 0 to t. E power, sorry, I am going to integrate this, so integral will not be there. So, e power minus u divided by minus 1 the whole squared plus 1 squared into a sin, a is minus 1. So, minus of sin u minus b, b is 1 cos of 1x, so cos u from 0 to everything from 0 to t. So, which is equal to wherever you have with respect to u, we have integrated. So, replace u by t. 1 by 2. This I am going to take it outside. Minus 1 the whole squared is 1. 1 plus 1, 2. So, 1 by 2 into e power minus u into minus also I can take it outside. So, e power minus u into sin u plus cos u from 0 to. Now you can apply u is equal to upper limit, that is minus 1 by 2 into e power minus t into sin t plus cos t minus of, when you apply a lower limit, e power 0 into sin 0 plus cos 0. That is sin 0 is 0. So this term will be 0. This cos 0 is equal to 1. Okay. Therefore, minus if I take it out inside, so 1 by 2 into, here minus and minus it will become plus. So, it is plus 1 minus e power minus t into sin t plus cos t. This is the answer. Okay. Next question is, find L inverse of 1 by a squared plus a squared the whole squared. So, here both if this can be written as L inverse of 1 by a squared plus a squared into 1 by a squared plus a squared. Okay. So, that is now f bar of s is equal to 1 by a squared plus a squared and g bar of s is equal to 1 by a squared plus a squared. So, f of t is equal to L inverse of 1 by a squared plus a squared. Here, a is missing. So, multiply and divide it by a. So, 1 by a into sin a t. In similarly, g of t also is the same. So, g of t is equal to 1 by a into sin a t. So, L inverse of 1 by a squared plus a squared the whole squared is equal to f of t star g of t. That is integral 0 to t f of u. F of u is 1 by a into sin a u into 1 by a into sin a into t minus u. Wherever you have t, replace it by t u and t minus u respectively into du. That is equal to 1 by a squared, I can take it outside. Integral 0 to t sin au into sin of at minus au into du. We know that 2 sin a sin b formula is, here you have product, so you cannot integrate just like that. You have to write it as a sum of two functions. Okay. So 2 sin a sin b is equal to, we know that 2 sin a sin b is equal to cos of a minus b minus cos of a plus b. Here a is equal to au and capital B is equal to at minus au. Okay. So what is a minus b is equal to au minus at plus au. That is 2au minus at. That is our a minus b. What is a plus b? It is au plus at minus au. Au, au will get cancelled. It is at. That is a plus b is equal to at. So, this is equal to 1 by a squared into integral 0 to t. Here you have 2 sin a sin b. So, 2 is not there. Multiply and divide it by 2. Okay. So, 2 sin au sin at minus u. So, cos of a minus b. So, cos of 2au minus at minus of cos at into du, which is equal to 1 by 2a squared into, if you integrate this with respect to u, so sin 2au minus sin 2au, no? Sin cos, integration is sin 2au only. Minus at divided by 2a. That is for integration of first term. Minus cos at is with respect to u, you are integrating. So, u into cos at from 0 to t. Okay. Cos at is like a constant because you are integrating with respect to u. So, u into cos of at. That is 1 by 2 a squared into, now you substitute t. So, u is equal to t. So, sin of 2 a t minus a t divided by 2 a minus t cos a t. This is for upper limit. Minus for lower limit. Minus 0 into, so sin of A is equal to 0. So minus 80 divided by 2a squared minus u is equal to 0. This term will become 0. Okay. Therefore, it is equal to 1 by 2a squared into 1 by 2a sin 280 minus 80. So sin 80. Sin 80 minus t cos 80. T cos 80 plus this minus, sine of minus is minus, minus and minus, it will become plus. Sorry, here why it is 2a squared? It is 2a only. 2a only. Okay, 0 when you substitute 0, here 2a. So minus of 1 by, so minus minus, it will become plus. So plus 1 by 2a into sine 80. That is equal to, now you can take 2a outside so that it will become 1 by 2a cube into sin 80. Here 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, it will become 1. Okay, half plus half, it will be 1. And a square, 1a, I am taking it outside. So, sin 80 minus a into 1a only I have taken outside, so that a is not here. So minus 80 into cos 80. Understood? Here actually if you want, I'll write you one more step. 1 by 2a squared into 1 by 2a plus 1 by 2a. 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, which is 1. Okay. So 1 by 2a into 1 by 2a will be 1 by a only. So 1 by a into sin 80 minus t cos 80. And 1 by a, I am taking it outside. So 1 by 2a cube into sin 80. Here in the denominator you don't have a, so therefore multiply and divide by a. So 80 cos 80. This is the answer. One more problem we'll do, that is find L inverse of 1 by s minus 2 into s plus 2 the whole square. It looks very simple only, but you have to do it carefully. Okay. So find L inverse of, so f bar of s is equal to 1 by s minus 2 and g bar of s is equal to 1 by s plus 2 the whole square. So f of t is equal to 1 by L inverse of 1 by s minus 2. That is e power 2t, right? And g of t is equal to L inverse of 1 by s plus 2 the whole square, which is equal to s plus a form means you have to remember first shifting theorem, that is e power minus 2t into L inverse of, replace s plus 2 by a, so 1 by s squared, which is equal to t into e power minus 2t. L inverse of 1 by s squared is t. So t into e power minus 2t. Therefore, by convolution theorem, L inverse of 1 by s minus 2 into s plus 2 the whole square is equal to L inverse of 1 by s minus 2 into 1 by s plus 2 the whole square. That is f of t star g of t. That is equal to integral. By definition, it is integral 0 to t f of u. F of u is what? e power 2u. 1 by s minus 2. So e power 2u. E power 2u into g of t is t into e power minus 2t. So in the place of t, we have to write t minus u into e power minus 2 into t minus u into du. That is equal to integral 0 to t e power 2u into t minus u into e power minus 2t into e power 2u into du. So e power minus 2t is independent of u, I can take it outside. So integral 0 to t e power 4u into t minus u into du. Now let us split that. So e power minus 2t into integral 0 to t e power 4u du minus e power minus 2t into, or I can write with bracket, e power minus 2t into e power 4u into t. T also can be taken outside. Okay. T into e power 4u du minus integral 0 to t e power minus, I have taken outside. So u into e power 4u into du. Okay. That is e power minus 2t into t into e power 4u by 4. Right. Minus. Now integrate this. U, this is uv form. Integral uv dx, uv is equal to u into v1. Bernoulli's formula for integration by parts in extended formula. Okay. Minus u dash v2 plus u double dash v3 etc. U dash is du by dx. U double dash is d squared u by dx squared and so on. V1, v2 is integral v1. V1 is integral v. V2 is integral v1. V3 is integral v2 and so on. Okay. So first you have to take u into, first u into v1. V1 is e power 4u by 4. Okay. Then keep on differentiating the first bracket. Keep on integrating the second bracket. So if you integrate the first bracket, it is 1 into e power 4u. Already one 4 is there. So it is e power 4u into divided by 16. Okay. Everything from 0 to t. That is e power minus 2t into t into e power 4u by 4 minus, first let me expand this, minus, minus, I'm here you have minus of these two. These two terms are with minus. So I'm going to take it inside. Okay. E power t into e power 4u by 4 minus u into e power 4u by 4 plus minus and minus, it will become plus e power 4u by 16 from 0 to t. So if you have minus of something, you first you take it inside, then you apply the limits, otherwise we will get confused. Okay. So this is equal to e power minus 2t into t into, now you substitute u is equal to t for upper limit, u is equal to 0 for lower limit. So t into e power 4t divided by 4 minus u into e power 4t is t into, u is t. T into e power 4t by 4 plus e power 4t by 16. This is for upper limit, right? Minus, you substitute u is equal to 0. So t into e power 0 by 4 minus, this is for lower limit, so I am writing in the separate bracket, u is equal to 0 will be 0 plus e power 4, 4 into 0. So e power 0 by 16. Okay, that is 1 by 16. So that is equal to e power minus 2t into, here t into e power 4t by 4, t into e power minus t into e power 4t by 4, they will get cancelled. So e power 4t by 16 minus t by 4 plus 1 by 16. I can take 16 outside and e power minus 2t inside. So 1 by 16 into e power minus 2t into e power 4t minus e power t into e power minus 2t divided by 4 minus Here you have minus, right? So this will be minus t by and minus 1 by 16. So e power minus 2t by 16. E power minus 2t minus 4t, t by 4 into e power minus 2t minus e power 2t by 16. That's right. So this will become e power 2t into e power minus 2t into e power 4t. That is equal to 1 by 16 into e power 2t minus 4. Here you have 4. I am taking, sorry, here also 1 by 16. I am not taking it outside here. You just write 1 by 16 here. Now I am taking 1 by 16 outside. So 1 by 16 into e power 2t, e power minus 2t, e power 4t. So this will become e power 2t minus. Here you have in the second term only 4. I have taken 16 outside. So I have to multiply by 4. So 4t into e power minus 2t, right? Yeah. Then minus e power minus 2t. I am multiplying that by minus 2t. Yes. So you can stop here, or you can write one more step if you want. A 1 by 16 into e power 2t minus of 4t plus 1 into e power minus 2t. This is the answer. So almost all the types of problems in convolution theorem are covered. Please try to do on your own, practice these problems. One definite question you can expect for university exam also, using convolution theorem, find the inverse Laplace transform. Okay, hope this will be useful. Please give a like and share it with your friends so that it will be useful for them also. Thank you so much.